Deputy Gerry Adams.
Agus tá sagat hísach yormaid shui donvaru Ronan Kearney's lúcha agus dúirt mé go bhfuil sin féin leis an réaltas agus tá muid sin a leig leis teaghlach Ronan Kerr ag an uair brónach deacair in a héal agus bhí mé sa tuascart Jadoni agus Anye agus ag obair le Martin Macanesa agus Daniela and Shin, August Tamage go Han Solar, go well Dini, go well Fubble and Shearshaw, Winter and Shearshaw, and Aidan and Dunbaru Shin. We'll have a chance later, and I think it's very, very appropriate that the government has allowed space for a debate on the murder of Ronan Kerr, and we did discuss it earlier, Taoiseach. And it is of the utmost importance that we continue to make it very, very clear that we stand in opposition to this murder, that we stand with the Kerr family, and in the session later on this evening, we will have some opportunity to spell out in detail our views and also to chart a way forward. I want, if I may, to ask you about the ongoing economic situation. In the recent election, you said very, very clearly, the current IMF-EU bailout deal is bad for Ireland and bad for Europe. You said the financial markets are closed to Ireland principally because investors are concerned that any more capital injections into the banks will sink the Irish economy. You said the current, IMF-EU bailout plan will not restore confidence in Ireland because at its heart is a commitment to continue the failed banking policies of the present, that is, the Fianna Fáil government. Now, Taoiseach, having said all of that, and that was only a few short weeks ago, at every point in this chamber, at meetings at European level, at summits, you have said again and again and again that you're committed to this EU-IMF deal. And I just don't understand what kind of negotiating position that is. It strikes me as absolutely ridiculous that you give away your negotiating position again and again and again. And it's totally and absolutely unacceptable, and many people have said this to me, that you are doing the exact opposite to what you committed to only a few short weeks ago. And the Irish people are paying for that. So, Taoiseach, can you explain this departure? And secondly, could you explain or give some sense to the negotiating stance of the government, led to Hull?
Well, if those intim gacor gamach chainu an lodger a curamach on chacsha ille dunwaru Ronan Kerr. But the Dutch may be McConnell and Water Ne Water Nula, I guess the may fear Briot D. Asocht Keho Kroger, because the Toshigas and Mishnach, Leshanghia Laoshi Mach, Fween Dun Waruavik, I guess Tasulam and Urgos Mesus and Morak, an angel Leshan Hedara, I guess in Dara, Machin Machanisa, I guess Chachtiel on Chachsha. Gorkora lodger eshin, agari as often disport a vest and shahagin and new Augustin ruin a vest lakilesh gahumlan, a son gak tacht as a dolcho, gurishishin court a lodger a mark freshen. It's not a case of changing any position here, Deputy. The position is that we've had six dysfunctional banks. We proceeded in a path of confusion and uncertainty for so long that it was absolutely so frustrating for so many people, unable to have a government provide leadership of some sort to point a way forward to in a path where our country can get back to being in charge of its own economic destiny. And that's why the government last week made its decisions in respect of the banking sector. And this brings clarity and certainty to a position where we'll now have two pillar banks which will be the bulwark of the banking sector for the future in Ireland, and that's very clear and that gives certainty to it, which has now been recognised internationally and indeed by independent commentators today. It also means that the ECB, in their statement, following the government decision about the banking sector, confirmed that they will continue ongoing liquidity into the Irish banks, which is of extreme importance and fundamental importance to business and confidence here. Now, we have to rebuild the nature of our connections and our contact with our counterparts in Europe. And the Taoiseach and the government, all members of the government, will involve themselves in this very important work, so that it's understood by our European colleagues just how important it is in a European sense to show flexibility in the path that Ireland has to follow here, and which Ireland will follow. You're aware, Deputy, that the EU-IMF mission starts today and will last until the 15th of April. Much of this will be technical discussions about the intricacies of the instruments that are there. And the government will discuss the elements of the programme for government, such as upcoming programme for jobs initiative, which will have an impact on the indigenous economy here to stimulate investment. To provide confidence so that people who have been saving because of their fears of no certainty up front will have an opportunity to be able to spend in the Irish economy, which will grow confidence and hope and provide jobs.
Deputy Gerry Adams.
Na cortu fragra Taoiseach ar na cestion a cor mai ortsa sin were focal. These are your words. I didn't make them up. These are what people voted for. You talked about the five-point plan. Strikes me it's a five-point U-turn that we're engaged in here. Here are other words that people voted for. Fine Gael and government will force certain bondholders to share in the cost of recapitalising troubled financial institutions. This will be done unilaterally for most junior bondholders, but could be extended as part of a European-wide framework for senior debt, focusing on insolvent institutions like Anglo-Irish and Irish Nationwide that have no importance. You give 3 billion of the people's money, 3 billion euros, into those two institutions. And then, in terms of the U-turning, and with respect, there needs to be some clarity so that people can understand and have confidence, if that's possible, and what the governments are doing. Your party said that not one cent, not one red cent, would be committed to the banks unless they impose losses on their bondholders. And yet last week you poured another 24 billion, 24 billion of the people's money into those banks. So what price manifestos, what price election promises, what price election commitments? A very, very, very high price indeed, especially for people who are in economic distress at this time. And the other party of government, Labour's manifesto, it's been shredded. It's just been totally and absolutely shredded. And it's the Irish taxpayers who are paying not just for your U-turns, but also for the private greed of private bankers. And there is no sense of us coming out of this, and I'm by nature an optimist, and I believe we can find our way out of that, and this party has put forward suggestions for how to do that, but not by throwing good money after bad, Taoiseach.
Deputy Taoiseach.
Well, let me go back to what I said. The government's decision of last week brought about certainty and clarity insofar as the Irish banking sector is concerned. This is very important for business. It's been received in that light by international commentators and by the European Central Bank, by the European Commission and by the IMF. It's about time that somebody made a decision in respect of the Irish banking sector. Now, this government looked at the position of 6 dysfunctional banks, of a country that couldn't borrow money on the international markets, of banks that couldn't borrow money, where every cent coming in here was being provided from abroad. So from that point of view, the government's decisions bring clarity and certainty to that. That's been followed by clarity from the ECB in respect of their ongoing commitment to liquidity into the Irish banking system, which is very important for the start of a growing confidence and to get that back into our economy. The Thursday's payments of 2.5 billion and 530 million from the Exchequer to Anglo-Irish Bank and INBS arise from the promissory note made by the previous government. And I said on many occasions, there is no point in not telling the people what the facts of life are. And that's a fact of life, that for the next 10 years, Deputy Adams, these payments are going to have to be made at this time. And that's, when you open the press, this is what we found. Part of what we found. So that's an imposition and a burden that you know that we could deal with the issue of the Ulster Canal and a lot of other places in the northwest or any place around the country. But that's a fact of life. So in respect of the decisions that were made by government, they do bring clarity and they do bring certainty to the banking sector, and that's important. Now the IMF EU Troika are here until the 15th of April, and they will involve themselves in their technical discussions to see that where the country is in respect of the programme that was agreed between the sovereign state of Ireland, the people of Ireland, by the IMF, EU, which we in opposition voted against on the basis of its interest rate being too high and because of other elements of the deal, notably the cost of the banking structure. And we didn't pursue the issue of having interest rate reductions until the bank stress tests were carried out. And these, as you know, have been absolutely robust, have been the most severe that have ever been carried out, and speak for themselves. Now, and that brings that clarity to that position. So we move on from here with those certainties in respect of the banking sector and ongoing liquidity to deal now with our European counterparts in rebuilding the reputation and the status of this country, which unfortunately was let slide to a position where suspicions existed about Ireland and where many of the comments made by our politicians were not believed for valid reasons in many cases.